Hey there guys, if you want to boost your 3D printing capabilities, possibly learn a cool super helpful trick in Fusion 360, or maybe you guys just want a tip on a customizable product that you could 3D print and sell, maybe to pay off your 3D printer and kind of appease your wife, then stick around because I got you covered. Today I'm going to show you exactly how to make customizable 3D printed morale patches. Okay. So now if you're asking yourself, what the hell is a morale patch? Let me explain it to you. A morale patch is basically a logo or an insignia, usually with a catchy phrase that you can kind of stick on your gear or jacket with Velcro. And this is a super popular item in military and law enforcement circles. Therefore, it's also a super popular item in a whole bunch of hobbies as well. For example, Nerf, Airsoft, cosplay, and paintball. Customizing a team logo or a unit insignia and slapping it onto a morale patch can make you some good money. And I really think it's a cool item in and of itself. So if this is something that interests you, stick around and let's get into it. Okay, so there's a few things that you guys are going to need first. If you've seen my name tag tutorial, this might sound a little familiar, but the first thing you're going to need is a 3D printer. It's better to get a 3D printer with an direct drive extruder, but it's not necessary. The second thing you guys are gonna need are at least two different colors of 95A shore hardness TPU. Why 95A shore hardness TPU? Because 95A shore hardness TPU gives you a really good flexible patch that you can stick on your clothes. The third is some Velcro strips, and the fourth is some JB Weld epoxy, which is pretty awesome stuff for sticking 3D printed things together. By the way, I put some affiliate links down for everything you're gonna need in the description below. Once you've got all that stuff together, the next thing you're gonna need is an SVG file of the logo you're gonna wanna make. For those of you that don't know, an SVG file is essentially a vector image file, kind of like a PNG, but not exactly. I'm not gonna get into that in this video. You don't need to know how to use Adobe Illustrator to be able to get an SVG image. You can easily download them from online. If you can't find the image that you're looking for that you want to put on that morale patch, it only costs about 10 bucks on Fiverr to get somebody. Send them an image of the logo you want to slap on that morale patch and they'll bang it out for you pretty quick. Send you that SVG file. So no worries there. So once you've got your SVG file of the image that you want on your morale patch, I'm going to show you exactly how to get this done super quick in Fusion 360. Really cool tip. So let's go. Okay, so once we're in Fusion 360, we're going to start out by choosing the top plane, and there we're going to start our sketch. Once we open the sketch, we're going to choose the center rectangle tool, and with that we can sketch out the outline of our patch. And using the sketch dimension tool, we're going to give our patch a length of 85 millimeters or 3.4 inches and a width of 55 millimeters or about 2 inches. Once we got our patch measured out, I'm gonna give the corners a radius of 5 millimeters, just cause I think it looks nice. And once we're done, we can extrude the patch 2 millimeters. Once we got our solid object, we can choose the top face. And now for the fun part, we're gonna go up to the insert option tool on our tool tab. And in the drop-down menu, we can choose insert SVG and pick the logo we want on our patch. For the purpose of this video, I'm gonna be using this 3D printed skull design I made. And once we have the SVG open, I see it's way too big and upside down. That's no good. So let's flip it vertically using the vertical flip button in the control tab on the right and scale it down to 0.2. Let's try it. Okay, now I can use this little white box to drag the image where I want it. Let's put in another image. I'm gonna pick my logo. Okay, scale it and position it over here on the right and hit okay. At this point, we're gonna finish the sketch, and now all we gotta do is pick the extrude option and choose which profiles are of our image we want to extrude. And with that, we can extrude our image. For this video, I'm taking it out about 2 millimeters, but you can do less if you want. Now check that out, that's pretty cool, I think. But Scully looks a little bit unbalanced. So let's put in some text over here on the left side. I think I'm going to just put in like three different text bodies so I can play around with the composition. And I'm gonna write 3D printing designer. I don't know. And with that, we can finish the sketch and extrude. But before we finish up, let's just give him a little rim, just because I think it looks cool. I'm going to start a new sketch on the top face of Scully. Choose the outer edge and pick this offset tool. Drag the offset of our edge until it looks good, finish, and extrude. And with that, we can save Scully and export him to an STL file. Okay, so if you don't have Fusion 360 or maybe you don't have an SVG file to try this out, I left a link also for the STL and also for the SVG down in the description below so you can try it out for yourself. So what good is this cool design if you can only print it out in one color? Well, no worries, because I'm going to show you exactly how to change the filament mid-print. By the way, if you guys are enjoying this video or you're finding any kind of value out of it, I would truly appreciate a subscribe and a like so I can keep getting better and sending out more content for you guys. Anyway, enough about that. Let's jump into Cura. Come on. Okay, so once we're in Cura, we can select the TPU preset setting. If you don't have a TPU preset setting, just like in my last TPU spotlight, I'm going to add a link to one down in the description. So once that's done, we can basically just pop Scully right into Cura. We rely on the TPU preset settings and the suggestions of your particular TPU filament provider to get the job done. I'm just going to change the speed for this print because I happen to have the sonic pad on my 3D printer. So I'm just going to ramp up the print speed and acceleration a little bit. That's what I'm doing here. By the way, if you're unfamiliar with the sonic pad, I have a whole other video review. You're gonna probably wanna check that out. But anyway, once we have all the settings fleshed out the way we want them, we can slice Scully and see where the main body layers are done and just the image and text start to print. And this is gonna be the layer we're gonna wanna change the color. For the purpose of this video, it's layer 11. So now we can get into the good stuff. The M600 G-code modifier. What we gotta do is go up to the extensions, post-processing, modify G-code, add a script, pick the filament change option, and check the use firmware configuration option. In Clipper, you're gonna need to add a printer config file for the Marlin 600 command to work, but that's for a whole other video. Once we got our script and we can basically reslice Scully and save him. Okay, once that's done, we're almost ready, but not quite. The last thing we're gonna need to do is dry out our TPU. So I mentioned this in the name tag tutorial I made, but chances are you probably haven't seen it. So let me just tell you, TPU is a thirsty filament. It sucks moisture out of the air like a cactus. If you don't dry it properly, it'll be spitting out all kinds of steaming boogers all over your patch. And you're gonna have to pick that off afterwards, picking out all the little boogers from your patch. It's kind of crazy. So to dry your TPU filament, you can use a dedicated TPU filament dryer. But since mine sucks, I'm gonna try to sneak it into the oven so my wife doesn't see. And once that's done and your TPU filament is dry, we can finally bang out the print. At layer 11, the print is gonna stop and retract the filament so you can swoop in with the new color and hook it in. Once the new color is all switched out, you can press play. Print is gonna continue. Boom, you got your morale patch. Okay, so now that Scully is done, we can finish him off with a little bit of post-processing, any little boogers or strings that are left over from the print. Smack on some JB Weld epoxy, slap on that Velcro, let him dry, and you're done. I truly hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, you might enjoy this one next. And that's it for now, guys. Bye.